Hi, I'm Jane Connolly, president of Cal State Long Beach, and I want to share yet another OneBeach message with you. In previous messages, we've seen teams of beach professionals deep cleaning campus classrooms, heard from alumni healthcare heroes who are working tirelessly, discussed how faculty and staff are preparing for alternative means of instruction, and we watched our colleagues doing some of the important work that keeps our campus open and operating. While our on-campus classrooms and labs have been empty since March, scholarship at the beach has forged on. Research conducted by our faculty and students, though slowed by some of the challenges posed by COVID-19, has continued. Pandemic or no pandemic, manuscripts still have to be reviewed, experiments monitored, and observations made. Our campus environment may look different these days, but the scholarly and creative work continues. There are stories across campus at each of our colleges that exemplify the One Beach spirit when it comes to research by our faculty and students. One story that is highlighted in a recent edition of Scientific American focuses on our world-famous shark lab. Headed by Professor Chris Lowe, the shark lab's work has received special attention for its study of the white shark. As Chris and his team discover new ways to observe the near-mythic fish, especially in waters just off Long Beach and other California cities. The pandemic's health and safety restrictions have made it a little tougher to do their work, but it hasn't stopped Dr. Lowe and his students in the shark lab as they continue to learn about the sharks and find new ways to better ensure the safety of beachgoers. I've asked Chris to tell us a little bit about what the shark lab is doing and how they're doing it. Chris?
When the COVID shutdown hit, I was in the middle of teaching a class that it was great to get together with grad students and meet with them. You know, we do a lot of interactive things, and then suddenly that stopped. And I had to switch to doing Zoom lectures. But at the same time, I was trying to ramp up for a shark season that I didn't know how big it was going to be. And it turns out to be a big one. So I spent much of that early shutdown writing safety protocols so that I could get my people in the field. And because many of my staff are considered essential employees, because we work very closely with lifeguards, it was important for them to be able to get out right away because people were in the water, even though the shutdown was happening, and lifeguards were responsible for people's safety. Safety obviously is our number one concern, but at the same time, we have jobs to do, and the students have jobs to do. And our graduate students actually have to do research to get their degree. So it can't just be all online for them. They have to be able to get in the lab. They have to get into the field. So developing methods and procedures for them to do that safely has been really my number one priority. Really fortunate that the administration's work with us helped us move these things forward. And we've been operating for 3 months with no incidents, which is great. 2 years ago, we got funding from the state of California to expand our white shark research education program, focusing primarily on beach safety. So we work with all the municipalities throughout California to provide them with good current scientific information about white sharks, particularly white shark nurseries in Southern California. So my team has been out tagging sharks. We have receivers all along the coast that we have to maintain and download. Soon as we get that information, we give it to lifeguards so that they have real-time science information. We have real-time buoys that they get cell alerts, you know, if a shark has been detected at a buoy off Huntington Beach or Belmont Shore, Santa Barbara. But we're also flying drone surveys all along the coast, and we've been doing that every month from Santa Barbara to San Diego. And then those drone surveys are used for a couple purposes. One is we want to know when people are in the water with sharks, but we don't actually know how many people are in the water. So despite the fact that people are using the ocean for a wider range of recreation, we don't know who's in the water, when they're in the water, and when they're in the water with sharks. So while most of our focus is on shark behavior, why are sharks at this beach? Why are they coming here and why do they leave? What we don't understand are human behavior, which puts people in close proximity to the sharks. So our research right now is gathering a little bit of both. What are people doing and where are they? And then can we correlate that to environmental condition?
Wow. That is remarkable work that our shark lab is conducting under Dr. Lowe's direction. But as I noted before, it's just one example of the scholarship that goes on every day here at the beach. I am proud that our faculty and students are actively involved in the generation of research of regional, national, and international importance. Research is often considered the domain of major land-grant and private research universities, and teaching is often viewed as the heart of the CSU's mission. But both are vital aspects of a beach education. We are a test bed of innovation, creativity, discovery, and evidence-informed revisions of prevailing beliefs. Our job is to imagine what has not yet been substantiated, and it's the ongoing work done by faculty and students that allows all of that to happen. So to all the beach scholars out there who have continued to study, work, and deliver new knowledge, despite the challenges of the pandemic, thank you. Your dedication, your One Beach spirit, is making a difference. Until our next message, be well, be safe, and remember, we are One Beach.